I'm still alive, don't worry. He pushed me out of the palace, but luckily I landed on this thing. Yeah, it's a bit uncomfy, and the fact that I don't have a lot of things to do here is a bit boring, but I managed to get some service up here, somehow. And I watched a video that I had a problem with. A few problems, actually. And since I need to fill my rant quota, here we are. Meet Fran, ex-ranter and commentator, now talks about art and stuff. Commented on one of my videos wishing to vor it because it was good or something. Pretty chill person. Not really in a bad boat with her. Yeah. She is not what I take issue with. Moreover, it's one of her recent videos titled Every Art Style Ever. Which already caught my attention, and not in a good way. So, without further ado, let's get into the video.
Hi everyone! So today I'm going to be talking about something that I think isn't talked about enough, and it's an issue I think we have in today's contemporary art era. And it's the fact that the majority of artists between the ages of like, what, 12 and 15 through 16 basically have the exact same art style. And I think it's damaging people's art development.
Nice generalization. Huh. Also, what I understand is that all these people having the same art style, practically, at a certain age might just be a learning thing as opposed to a hindrance in said learning. Looking ahead in your video, I believe that I had some of these issues with my art when I was just starting. However, I changed my art style from that. You're making it seem as if these people will never improve, which is simply false.
I dug into Deviantart to find some examples of artists like these to kind of represent the art style I'm talking about, and these are the people that I picked. Renari, Yovio, Marbleach, Ultrash, and Minky. Thank you guys for watching this video.
Hi!
I hope none of you get offended by anything that I'm gonna say in this video, because I'm not trying to offend you, I'm actually just trying to, like, you know, give my opinion and just point out things that I notice in people that have similar art styles to yours, so. Yeah, just trying to give critique and stuff.
Sure, Fran. Sure. Critique. I get it. Yeah, I know what you're talking about. You're not gonna nitpick anything in this video. Jesus.
Before we take a look at ourselves, let's dive into what I personally think this whole middle of using ourselves is happening. It's happening by 2013 to use the like cartoonish art everybody uses 12 or 15 to 16. It's kind of a mush of the same thing, and you kind of start to not be able to tell artists. It's starting to get, you know, people worse when the Hamilton, 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 the
People have dubbed this art the Tumblr art style because that's where you mostly see this kind of art. Because, you know, Steven Universe is kind of an SJW show, so that's where all of the art goes, onto Tumblr, the SJW website.
I'm sorry, what? Steven Universe is an SJW show. And so, by that logic, since, Steven Universe is on Tumblr. Are you saying that every show with a fanbase on Tumblr is SJW in nature? Because one, Steven Universe is not inherently SJW. Being SJW means that the show would argue rudely or shallowly about issues regarding the internet or progressive matters. While the show is progressive and appeals to those people, that doesn't mean that the show itself is SJW. And two, a lot of the stuff on Tumblr regarding fandoms are not SJW entirely. Also, I'm gonna play this little bit from Natasha ZM's video because, yes, and I agree with it. It's a good point. Go watch her video, by the way.
Yep, yeah, that's what did it. All Steven Universe. Surely it wasn't the trend of simplified animation started and featured by shows like Adventure Time in 2010, My Little Pony, 2010. Regular Show, 2010. The Amazing World of Gumball, 2011. And Gravity Falls in 2012.
However, I've noticed this art style on other websites too, like on DeviantArt and on Twitter. So I've given it the name Every Art Style Ever.
Yet, all your examples, and only being five might I add, who probably didn't give you permission to use their art, period, are from DeviantArt. You could have at least taken people from Twitter or Tumblr and even it out a little bit, but no. And you called it the Tumblr art style, but everyone is on DeviantArt. And you're saying that it's every art style ever, however, they're only from DeviantArt. You should have just called it the DeviantArt art style, but no. Also, you're generalizing again. Stop it!
I don't know the exact origin of this art style, but that's just my take on it. That's how I've seen it from my perspective. So yeah, I'm going to be pointing out things like that I see a lot in this art style, like super common mistakes and just stuff that happens, and then I'm going to talk about why it hinders your art improvement.
First thing I'm going to be talking about is faces. The first thing I want to point out is the fact that the faces and all of the features look the same. Always. Let's take a look at Renari's art style, for example. I rounded out her art styles into two, which I've also seen in other people's art. Her first is more Steven Universe-esque.
Steven Universe-esque? How exactly? Because while there might be a small resemblance in the mouth or ears shapes, the rest definitely does not scream Steven Universe to me. At all. The eye shapes are different. Shading, position and expression, color choice, face shape, colored lines, defined nose, and other facial features make this style and piece look way different from Steven Universe. Unless you're watching a different kind of Steven Universe, and then that might explain a lot.
And then her second one is extremely cartoony. Let's take a look at the first. Now, if you look at these pictures, wow, receding hairline, who? Now, if you take a look at these pictures and think, wow, these all look the same, but I don't know, maybe I'm just messing up. Maybe I'm just, I don't have an eye for art. You're actually right. It is all the same. Structurally, it's literally the same picture. I've gone ahead and highlighted all of these things for you.
Well, then that's not a Steven Universe style, that's same face syndrome, which yes is a thing, and if you disagree with it, then we can tussle behind a Wendy's. Fight me in a parking lot of Wendy's. Anyway, the face shapes are all the same. It's pretty obvious. It's not a Steven Universe issue, it's a stylistic issue. And looking at your other examples, not every art style has this issue. You're making it seem like it does.
I'm not just accusing Renari of doing this, I'm, like, talking about all of the other artists mentioned in this list, because they all just have the same face, but I just decided to take Renari as a primary example.
No examples? You have four other people. Okay then, still feels like at this point you're calling them out, as opposed to making it seem like everyone has this style, or issue, whatever.
I would like to be the one to introduce you guys to this amazing thing, concept, given us by God. It's called different face shapes. I know it's like amazing, we all have different face shapes. I know, just like, look at those faces. Isn't that amazing? I mean, wow.
Like I said earlier, I had a few issues with my art style when I was in the age range Fran declares this Tumblr art style occurred. This is one of those issues. I used to draw all my characters the same way, still do for some, but I've gotten better. Fran here is making it seem like this person doesn't know that different face shapes exist, somehow, and is coming off as condescending, and that this is a temporary issue, same face syndrome, is gonna kill their art style. Which it won't. Because you can get out of it, you know, it's temporary. There's something called looking at actual references and using them, which is what I did in order to get out of same face syndrome. This whole, like, art style issue is temporary. Do you not realize this? Because art styles can change. They're not gonna be like this forever, especially with critiques and references being used.
What? Can you bring it? Can you not have it? Yeah. Alright. My mom gave me pasta, so I'm gonna be eating. Sorry if that grosses you out.
So, professionalism has just gone out the window at this point? Huh. I'm gonna go get some food.
So yeah, like, different face shapes are a thing, and I know it's, like, quite surprising. And not all of the ears that you draw have to, like, be Dumbo ears. Like, they could just, like, fly away. I don't know, they literally look like they could just fly away.
Wow! How polite and totally unoffensive, Fran! Not like that person worked really hard to perfect their art style, most likely for many years, only for you to come along and shit on it.
So yeah, ears have a shape. Ears aren't just circles. I know that's just your art style. But you do it on every single human, so, yeah.
Wow, informative! Not? I mean, it is a bit helpful, but you insulting the way that they draw this one teeny tiny little thing is kind of dumb. And then you negate your point by saying,
I know that's just your art style.
Like it helps. It doesn't, especially when you're trying to critique their art style and get them out of what they're doing. Just brushing it off and saying, oh, I know it's just your art style. It negates everything that you just said. Saying that you don't care if they take your critique or not. Because it's just their art style.
I know it's like a really popular thing to draw ears like that, but normal ears, they look fine too. Don't be racist against normal ears.
Popular? How, exactly? I rarely see anyone draw ears like that, to be honest. I've seen them more like this, where it's just, you know, kind of sticking out, or just hidden under the hair.
And another amazing concept, different noses exist too. I mean, look at these noses. Isn't that just fantastic? Noses are great. They're a blessing. I'm glad we can breathe oxygen.
There's the condescending nature everyone loves. Not really. Also, this was something I struggled with as well. Danny is a great example. His nose used to look like this, but now it's more like this. The hawk type, I guess. Again, Fran, you're making it seem as if this type of art style is going to stay with this person forever, and that it'll hinder their style and art in the long run. When it really won't. Styles change all the time. It's not like this person will keep this style forever, especially if or when they go to college and get critiques like this one. Not to mention, they technically have two styles, which is what you said in the beginning. Therefore, this one style really doesn't matter, and they could just switch between the two.
And the reason why I highlighted the eyes is because all of those eyes are drawn the exact same, and I've noticed this a lot with people that have similar art styles. But I mean, like, look at these eyes. I personally just, like, love the Western way of drawing eyes because they're, like, really diverse. But if anime is more of your thing, then there you go. And of course, Renari has her secondary art style, and once again, it's all the same. So I'm not gonna bother repeating myself, but yeah, there you go. Practically the same. Basically, it's what I just said, you know, it's all the same, same faces, everything.
Then why did you separate them in the first place? If you have the same issues with both styles, wouldn't it just have been easier and quicker to lump them together? I know, generalization, but it works here because it's the same issues and the same person. Not many different kinds of people and styles like Fran's doing with this video.
Like, I wouldn't be able to tell these characters apart if it wasn't for the horns. But, I've seen other people with this art style, you know, like, huge, huge circular heads, like, bigger than the rest of their body, huge circle eyes, and a normal body, and then really thin arms and legs, and then huge feet, and really huge hands, but, anyways.
No, continue. Honestly, that is an issue, an anatomy issue, and anatomy is hard to understand 100%. However, Steven Universe and other shows with cartoony styles made this work. With cartoons, anatomy can be stretched, squashed, and altered to fit a certain more cartoony look or style. Or else, you know, if you don't really do that, then it's not really cartoony anymore, is it? It's not. Unless you're like those adult shows that, like, I forgot the name. I'll probably look it up later. It's probably going to be on screen right now. But, you know, those kind of shows that, you know, go for more anatomically correct styles, right? But for cartoons, like children's cartoons, they don't really need to because they're just cartoon characters. Does that make sense? I feel like I'm not making sense. This part is unscripted. I'm sorry.
With this, I'd like to come to talk about mouths and how there's basically two different ways of drawing mouths in this art style, and then, you know, everything else is just like a mush, a fusion of these two mouths. So I've gone ahead and made a chart for you guys. The first one is closer to Renari's style, and the second one is like, you know, more Steven Universe-esque that I see a lot of people use. Another thing with every art style ever, you can have the mouth go all the way like here. Like, the person is like smiling like, huh, but the mouth will like, it'll be like, huh.
Actually, Renari's art style doesn't even fit that, and hell, exaggeration is a big thing in cartoons, so it would fit in a cartoony art style. Come on, have you ever seen a cartoon with no exaggeration? Exactly, because that would be boring.
And it'll go up to, like, the eye. I don't know what that demonstration just was, but, just have a picture of it on screen. As you can see, like, the mouth is, like, not where it's supposed to be.
It's exaggeration, Fran. That's what that's called. It's a cartoony art style, so the exaggeration and misplacement of the mouth is okay. Because it's not following anatomy 100%. And while I do think, you know, you should take anatomy, or, like, at least try to understand anatomy a little bit before, like, developing your art style fully, it's not really required. Unless you have, like, one arm that's way shorter than the other one, and it's not, like, things aren't proportionate. Does that make sense? Like, if the body is not proportionate to what it's, what species or what character it's supposed to be based off, then that's just plain up wrong and you should fix that. Anatomy is confusing, trust me.
Marbleish suffers immensely from Steven Universe mouth syndrome. That's what I like to call it. And Yopio suffers more from the first style of mouth, you know, having two dots. I mean, we do have, like, you know, two dots for the mouth, but anyways.
But, okay, you've been pushing for, like, a more realistic style and, like, actually looking at, you know, anatomy and, like, people. And then you point out that this person has the two dots that we have, indicating that they look at real-life references and or other art styles that reference that. Therefore, they're doing something right, yet you criticize it and then move on. Fran! When you do a critique, you have to look at both the good and the bad. You do realize this, right? Or did the whole rant thing that you claim that you don't do anymore get in the way of that? Because this is a rant, this is not a critique in my eyes.
But then it's like the mouth just does whatever it wants to. There's really no structure to it because, you know, they don't draw the lips, so the mouth can just, like, do whatever it wants. It's kind of weird to me, but whatever. Whatever floats your freaking boat.
Okay, so wait. If you don't care if anyone, you know, takes your critique and advice, then why are you making this video? You clearly want to help people out, and I commend you for that. That's good. But saying, you know, whatever floats your freaking boat negates all your critique.
But let me introduce you guys to another fantastic concept. It's called different types of lip.
Let me also introduce you to an amazing concept. It's called stopping hypercritical of everything people do and nitpicking what people draw. Okay? So what if these people don't have lips? Cartoons? Friggin' Steven Universe, Adventure Time, Gumball, none of the main characters have lips. Those are big cartoons. It doesn't matter if you have lips or not. Well, okay, actually Garnet has lips, but they're clearly not vital to the character, like, development and, like, character design, rather. So, like, I don't know why you're being so critical of it. Okay, Steven Universe, right? They really only have one type of mouth. It's like the rounded sort of mouth. CalArt style, okay? I'm saying, you know, these shows have similar styles of mouth, and it's not a big deal, clearly. But you're making it seem as if it is a big deal. It's like only, like, one part of the face. Doesn't matter. The other parts of the face can, like, make up for that. Oh, you don't draw a mouth, you're instantly bad. Like, no! You can still change your art style. This stuff is not going to be with you forever.
Here's some, you know, normal Western style lips. And then here's some anime lips, if you're into anime lips, mouths, you know, whatever is your thing.
But that's a style of lip too. At this point, you're just heavily suggesting that they change their entire art style to something else. Like I said earlier in this video, that's not helping. That style of lip is perfectly fine for the art style that they're going for. As long as it fits everything else within the style, it should not be a problem.
The same nose is very prominent too. People like to dub this as the Tumblr nose because, you know, people that draw with this type of nose, you know, their art is primarily found on Tumblr. I've already showed examples of Frenari, but here's Old Trash rocking that Tumblr nose, you know. And Yopio has really intense Tumblr nose, and Minky here displaying her awesome Tumblr nose.
Those noses look barely alike, Fran. What the hell are you saying? Romari's noses look different from these noses. They aren't as defined. Old Trash's nose is more rounded, Yupio's nose is more sharp and pronounced, and Minky's nose is simply simplified. I see little to no resemblance in these noses. Also, please stop calling things Tumblr this or Tumblr that. You literally said in the beginning that this stuff is in every art style ever, quote unquote, and these issues are found in art both on Twitter and DA. So calling it the Tumblr art style makes no sense. Just call it Every Nose Ever or something like that, which isn't even correct, but whatever.
I think that pretty much covers the face section. To those who are starting to recognize the fact that they suffer from every art style ever style, what you can do is watch speed paints from people that have, like, really unique art styles. Something I've done when I was, like, struggling because I kept drawing the same thing, and so if you look at other people draw completely differently than how you draw, it'll really influence you and what you draw. I don't know why it's weird, but it works personally.
Oi, okay. While I agree with this, don't just look at other people's art styles, okay? Using real-life references for bodies and anatomy and even, like, backgrounds and character development helps way more. Art schools prefer that, actually, which is why life drawing classes are offered and even required at some art schools. Looking at other people's art is fine, and, you know, okay for, like, inspiration, and helpful for inspiration and all, but, you know, actually looking at life and looking from life and drawing from that is more beneficial than just looking at other people's art styles, because they can have issues in their art style that you won't realize unless you look at real-life references, like in terms of anatomy and, like, face shape.
Drawing with the every art style ever style really hinders your art progress, because when it comes to drawing faces, when you draw literally the exact same face over and over again, your brain just gets so used to it, and you're not giving your brain the opportunity to step out of its comfort zone. And if you don't draw different face shapes or different ears, mouths, eyes, and noses, you're probably going to be stuck drawing the same thing over and over and over again.
Again, I had some issues with, like, face shapes and facial features and such, but I grew out of that. Fran, again, is making it seem like you'll never grow out of your art style, which simply isn't fair or true. At this point, yes, they are stuck, but eventually, with help like this, okay, actually, that part's wrong, with critique and nitpick like this, they can expand their skills and try to push themselves to draw something new. Eventually. calling this help isn't exactly the best, because it's really just a bunch of nitpicks. If you want to improve, you really want to listen to critique, or look at other people critiquing other people, and look at your own art style in terms of that critique.
And then, you know, it'll be really hard to improve. So, yeah, that's my two cents on why I think it hinders you from reaching your full potential. It really does kind of sadden me because these artists are so good at coloring. Like, I wish I was this good at coloring. Like, they're good at everything else. It's just the anatomy and their proportions that are just so off and kind of weird. Whatever, I hope that advice will help someone out there. So, let's go on to our next section. The bodies.
But before that, anatomy, again, is okay to mess around with in a cartoony art style. Cartoonists do that all the time. Cartoons do that all the time. It's what makes their style, you know, look cartoony and gives it flair. SpongeBob, Steven from Steven Universe, Gumball from The Amazing World of Gumball, Peter Griffin from Family Guy, and Bugs Bunny from Bugs Bunny, I think, all have different body shapes and are exaggerated in some way, shape, or form. That's a good thing. It's a cartoon thing. It helps their silhouette, which is actually one of the most important things in designing a character, look, you know, unique.
I don't see too much of an issue with how these people draw bodies, because everyone kind of draws them differently.
But I do see the same mistakes with every one of them. Like, I've noticed the proportions are always really off, and it's weird. Or they just never draw bodies, and they only draw headshots, like Minky does. Here's a picture I've decided to use as an example. For this one, I used I've used art made by Yopio, and as you can see, the legs are two completely different sizes. Like, I know one of them is lifted up, but does your leg shrink when you lift it up in real life? I don't think so. If you do, you should probably see a doctor for that.
Yeah, I have a similar issue with my art. I've seen a lot of artists have issues with body proportions, mainly because they don't look at and practice anatomy, and find tricks on how to help them out with drawing it, and looking at other people's art styles to figure it out instead of looking at, you know, real life. Oh wait, but I said that was okay. It is, to an extent. Body proportions can be messed with, certain things should stay, which is why looking at real life proportions as opposed to cartoon proportions is more beneficial. Like, you don't want a cartoon character with their arms way too short and way not proportionate to their body, or else it just looks really weird. I mean, even with, like, my cartoon characters, me, I'm a cartoon character, technically. And, you know, I try to be proportionate. Although I'm made of goo and I could just kind of stretch if I want to.
Another thing I've highlighted is that the body is leaning forward, making everything else really unproportionate to what the pose is supposed to be. And that's something I've noticed a lot with beginner artists, is how they always make their characters lean forward, and I'm just like, stop. So I've gone ahead and corrected it based on the pose she was trying to achieve. I kind of messed up on the foot. The foot is actually on the ground and not kind of like floating along with the other leg, and the other leg is actually the same size as the one that's on the ground, and her body is straight up.
Actually, it's not. I can tell just by looking at it, but I also did a little doodling and editing just to show you. Good job, you failed at your own advising.
Here's another example, this art is by Minky, of the proportions being incorrect with basically the same pose. The only difference is that one arm is shorter than the other.
Well, the character's body is angled, so of course the arm would be shorter because of the angle. If they were T-posing straight at us, then, you know, there would be an issue. But they're not. Good job, you fell out your own advising. Again.
The reason why I'm highlighting proportions is because, you know, if you don't, you kind of are, you start thinking, like, maybe I'm wrong, maybe I'm just, you know, not looking at this correctly. And so you kind of brush it off, but if you actually go in and draw the proportions and the shapes, then you start to notice the mistakes. So, yeah.
If something looks wrong, go and fix it using a reference, kids. An actual reference. It helps.
This art here is by Marbleach. I've picked this one out because I noticed that people that draw with this art style never really draw knees or any proportion to the leg whatsoever. It just ends up looking like one long sausage with feet attached to them. And they seem to draw really tiny bodies with no waist. But those are people that draw closer to the Steven Universe style, so yeah.
I'm sorry, but are you dissing my body type? Because I have that exact body type. Do you want to fight me in a parking lot, Fran? You want to go to Wendy's and fight? Because, you know, that body type is okay. Not to mention, they do have a waist. It's right here.
When I first looked at this art, it's by Old Trash, I couldn't really tell what was wrong with it, but then I realized something's off, but I just couldn't tell.
I can just by looking at it. The arm is too small, along with that leg, so it looks wonky.
So I went ahead and highlighted the shapes and proportions, and then I took away the background. And now you can see what I'm talking about.
The torso is not that large in all actuality. The bagginess of the jacket makes it seem that way. That's not the issue. That part's actually fine, but because of the bagginess of the, you know, sweater, it makes it look screwed up to you, apparently. Hun, Fran, no!
The head is really tiny compared to the body and the arms. The shoulders are really short, and then the forearm is really short, and the hands are huge. The body is basically just a square, and the legs are really long and oddly close together. I don't know if I'm making sense with this, but I hope I am.
Actually, yeah, that's legit. These are all issues. However, the torso made the image proportions you drew out weird, too. You see, I did a little tweaking of your example myself to see the real issue, which is the torso, yes, but it's not as big as you make it.
Now, you may be thinking, Fran, it's just their art style. A ton of cartoonists draw with weird proportions in their art. That's true. However, cartoonists need to make everything proportionate to each other. They need to make things harmonize so that it looks good. These artists don't do that, and they don't make things harmonize. To make things look good together with weird proportions, you need to first learn the basics of anatomy. You need to learn actual real-life proportions, because to break the rules of art, you have to first learn them.
That's what I've been saying. I'd actually say that with every example, except for Renari's, though. Their art's good, and I like it.
So here's some examples of anatomy proportions. And then, you know, from that, you can take it and modify it, but at the same time, keeping it proportionate all to each other. The reason why not practicing real-life anatomy hinders your art style is because it's kind of for the same reason as before. Your brain just gets so used to drawing the same thing that then when you try to draw something different, you realize that it looks bad and you feel like you're incapable of drawing anything else, so then you keep drawing the same way, and you know, it's just a loop that you get stuck in because you don't get out of your comfort zone, and so then you never improve. So yeah, that's just what I have to say about it. A lot of people have made videos on the Tumblr art style, and you know, I just wanted to give my opinion on it.
I'm kind of mad at that you didn't say this in your actual section of the critique, because at this point, I bet some people would have clicked off, especially, you know, making this, since this is like 15 minutes long, you know. It's great advice, and that's how I learned how to draw, and I wish everyone would follow it, but you said it a bit too late, Fran, which is why I said it earlier. 5 times, actually, I think. Somewhere around there. So, final thoughts. Fran, honey, my home slice, bread slice, dog. While I know you're not gonna watch this because you stated in a follow-up video that you don't watch any other people's videos responding to this one, I just want this to be a little learning experience for everyone watching this who wants to learn how to critique people and their art style. It's not hate, this is feedback. All the negative comments are there for a reason, and it's because this video was hateful, nitpicky, sarcastic, confusing, demeaning, and forceful. Exactly what a video like this should not be. I know you tried to help, and you gave some good advice, but it was one, too late, and two, clouded by your sarcastic and condescending comments throughout the video. I honestly think you forgot how to critique things as opposed to just ranting on them and tearing them apart. Because that's basically what this video was, tearing apart pieces and artists that you claim to have the same art style when there were clear differences between the styles. And the fact that you're lumping them as the same art style makes me worried. Genuinely worried. Not to mention all the generalizations. You only think of one show as the root cause of this issue, Steven Universe. You lump all these different art styles together, you show examples from only one site, while mentioning others. Generalizations are not good for critiques without substantial reason for doing it, which you did not provide. Your half-assed critique will harm these and other artists who will take them, just because you're a big YouTuber. They'll think they have to change their entire art style and the way that they draw stuff just because they don't want to be called out and borderline harassed for drawing some way that someone doesn't like. Someone as big as you doesn't like. You basically put all these people on a pedestal and sacrifice them to the art gods for their sins just because you thought they drew weird, and all of your audience just sat back and watched. Not to mention, you are the only one who sees this as an issue. I've not heard anyone talk about every art style ever before this video came out. You barely use examples, the examples you do provide are not diverse enough and really only come from Deviantart, your critiques are all opinionated, half-assed, and one-sided, and you don't take into account that their style works off other people's or that they're trying to work on their anatomy behind the scenes. You think that all these pieces, these very few pieces from each person's gallery, reflect them as a whole. They have minor flaws, but you amp that up and say that every piece has its issue and their style basically sucks eggs. Again, maybe this is just a step in their learning, because they're beginning artists after all, and art styles don't stay with the people forever. Art is a consistent learning experience and improves with practice and time. Now, don't get me wrong, there are issues with these people's art styles, I agree with you on that, but every art style has issues. No one is perfect in terms of drawing. No matter how hard they try or how long they draw, there will always be issues with their styles to someone else or themselves. And either you try to fix them, or you just play off of them, not tear the entire style apart like you did, Fran. That's what ranters do. And to me, you're still a ranter. Because at least a critique would have the courtesy to 1. Ask for permission to use the art shown in the video, 2. Not nitpick and tear apart so viciously these art styles, 3. At least be a little less salty, angry, and sarcastic, and 4. Actually give constructive criticism and look at both the good things and the bad things in terms of the art. Throughout the entire video, I can only recall you being positive towards these people's art styles 1 time, and even that was dripping with sarcasm and negativity. Let people draw what they want. It's 2019, cringe culture is a zombie horse at this point, continuing to be resurrected by people and rants like this one. Anime, cartoons, and other stylized art should be celebrated, not put down. You do not have to draw realistically if you don't want to, and no matter how many times people push you to do it, it's your art, your creation, your style, and you should be proud of it. Well, that concludes this video. If you like this video, please subscribe and like, and yeah. Now if you'll excuse me, I need to find a way to get off of this rock before the vessel starts freaking out. Probably already has, though. That's great. I'll see you later. Bye.